In this lecture, we are going to understand what is testing. We have two learning objectives under this topic. First objective is identify typical objectives of testing, and it is marked as K1. That means the questions are going to be direct from this topic. So you just need to remember the points. Second objective is differentiate testing from debugging. It is marked as K2. That means you need to understand this topic. But before we start with these objectives, we shall understand what is testing. So first of all, what we need to know is, in this syllabus, we need to understand testing in the context of software. That means we will discuss only about software testing. So what is software testing? Software testing is a way to assess the quality of the software and to reduce the risk of software failure in operation. Now let's try to understand this. Once the developer develops software, the software is not directly given to the user. Before giving it to user, the software undergoes a process to find out defects and risk associated with the software. And this process is called testing. And in context of software, this process is called software testing. Now let's see some application of software. First example is business application, and the second one is customer product. Example of business applications are when you go to airport to book your tickets, or when you go to supermarket to buy some items, or when you are working at your office. Software are all around us. And the example of customer products are washing machine, mobile phones, or coffee maker machine. They all contain software within them. So what is our expectation from these softwares? Our expectation is they shall work correctly whenever we use them. And to ensure this, testing of software is required. What will happen if the software does not work correctly? Such software are called as faulty software. And a faulty software can result in loss of money, time, reputation, or in extreme cases can result in injury or death. Now let's see some real-time example to understand this. This news was in market that one particular car company recalled 2,000 of its car due to issue with the front passenger airbag. Once such news hits the market, the share value of company goes down and results in huge loss of money. Now let's move to the second example, that is time. Once this car is in the garage, they undergo repair, and at the same time, the company has to do damage control, and all of these things takes a lot of time. Now let's move to the third example, that is loss of reputation. In 2014, there was a breach in security aspect of eBay software. That means the software was compromised. It was not working as expected. And if such news comes out, it results in loss of reputation. Now let's see the last example, that is injury or death. For an example, if the airbag system does not work as expected, then it can result in injury or death. So these were the four impacts of faulty software: loss of money, time, reputation, and injury or death. Now we will see some of the misconceptions about testing. First misconception is, testing only consists of running test cases, which is completely wrong, as testing is a process and it consists of many activities as listed here. It consists of test planning, test monitoring and control, test analysis and design, test implementation and execution, and finally test completion. We will discuss about each of these activities in detail in our future lecture, but for time being, you need to remember these activities in the same order as listed here. Second misconception is, testing only involves the execution of the component or system being tested. This is also false, as testing consists of both dynamic and static testing technique. In dynamic testing, code is executed, whereas in static testing, code is not executed. I will provide detailed lecture on this topic. For time being, just remember, testing consists of dynamic and static testing techniques. And the last misconception which we are going to discuss in this lecture is testing focuses entirely on verification of the requirement. This is also false, as testing focuses on both verification and validation of the requirement. Verification means to check, are we building product right? Whereas validation means to check if we built the right product. So verification comes into picture in the starting of the project, and validation comes into picture at the end of the product. So again, I will provide detailed lecture to explain difference between both. As of now, just remember, testing focuses on verification and validation of the requirement. Before we end this lecture, let's have a look into the important points. Testing is done to assess the quality of the software and to reduce the risk of software failure in operation. Next point is, faulty software can result in loss of money, time, reputation, and injury or death. Testing is a process and consists of different activities: test planning, test monitoring, test analysis, test design, test implementation, test execution, and test completion are the seven different activities described in this syllabus. And the last important point is, testing consists of static and dynamic testing and consists of verification and validation process. All these important points are available as a resource and attached to this video. Please find them.